legs, feeds it in. Deaner to win it. God, he's done it again! Travis Deaner and the Golden Eagles are the champions of TBT.
It can be said for every 2 minutes of championship celebration, there are 8 seasons of dedication, creativity, and sacrifice. TBT, the basketball tournament, turns 8 this summer, and its direction has never been more impressive. Through its 7 championships, there have been over 400 teams who have competed in America's best and only open basketball tournament. Over 5,000 of the best players from around the basketball universe have made each succeeding year this celebration of the game a unique tournament to remember. Year 8 will be even better as TBT welcomes a record 28 college alumni teams, all chasing the $1 million winner-take-all jackpot. It's world-class basketball on the most innovative stage in the game. Uniquely, it's the basketball tournament. Settle in and welcome to TBT season number 8. The $1 million prize remains the same, but the stakes have been raised. We are down to TBT's Final Four. We welcome you to Semifinal Sunday. We are live in Dayton, Ohio at the iconic University of Dayton Arena as Championship Week continues. Down to the last four, and here are the matchups today on ESPN. The first game coming up will match Boeheim's Army against Florida TNT, and then about 2:30, we'll have 2 6-seeds going at it, Team 23 and Blue Collar U. A very pleasant good day wherever you may be. Bob Rathman, Seth Greenberg, great to have you with us for our coverage of this championship week in TBT. And Seth, we're down to four. Only one team's going to walk out of here with $1 million on Tuesday night, but four quality basketball teams.
Four quality basketball teams and no marshmallows, because compete in the TBT and get to this point, you got to play hard, you got to play together, you better have good guard play, and you better understand the elam ending, because in the end, if you don't, you're going home, and $1 million is out the window.
Florida TNT is one of the surprise teams to make it all the way through to the semifinals.
Yeah, Florida TNT, led by Dominique Jones. He's got an NBA championship ring with the Dallas Mavericks.
Boeheim's Army is playing in its 7th TBT, but this is just the second time they've made it to the semifinals. They knocked out the defending champs yesterday in the Golden Eagles.
Tyrese Rice was terrific down this stretch, and maybe the most athletic team in the second game is Team 23, and they've got a professional scorer in Marcus Hall and 21 feet of length up front.
And the University of Buffalo alums will play Team 23. They are playing in their first TBT. The Bulls were an NCAA tournament darling a few years ago. Now they're just 2 games away from $1 million. Our first matchup features Boeheim's Army. You talked about Tyrese Rice. I think college basketball fans remember him from his outstanding career at Boston College, but this guy is a pro and he knows what winning time is all about.
He's a pro, he's won championships all over Europe. He had 46 against North Carolina as a junior. He can get to the rim, he has all different ways to finish, has a step back three, terrific elam ender, and he's also complimented by two other guys that didn't play at Syracuse, DJ Kennedy and DeAndre Big Daddy Kane. But this is a deep team, but this guy right here down the stretch, he is the finisher, the Mariano Rivera of the Boeheim's Army.
And the heart and soul of the club, of course, is Eric Diebendorf, and he's standing by with Jen Hale.
Bob, that is the perfect description of Eric Diebendorf, indeed. 7 years for Boeheim's Army and TBT, and he has been here for all of them. Eric, a lot of roster change. You recruited several people from outside the Orangeman family this time around, including Tyrese Rice. And even though he went to Boston College, I bet he's an honorary Orangeman now with what he's been doing for your squad. All of these fantastic elam endings. What does he bring?
Oh, I mean, leadership, experience. I mean, all these guys, the four guys outside of Cuse, I mean, without them, we wouldn't be here right now. So I think myself, Kevin, Adam, we all did a good job of recruiting these guys to come, and they've done what we thought they would.
Also in your starting lineup, another non-Orangeman out of St. John's, DJ Kennedy, the leading scorer for TBT. Everybody wanted him on their roster, and you got him. What makes him such a good fit for the squad?
He just does everything. Rebounds, scores, passes, defends. I mean, the value that these guys bring to the table, you can't really speak on it too much because they've been doing it for so long, the experience, the championships that they won. We're just glad to have him on our team.
Well, we can't wait to watch. Thanks for your time, Eric, and good luck.
Appreciate you.
Bob?
Jen and Eric, thank you. The Syracuse alums going up against a pretty good ball club here, Florida TNT. Seth, they've been around TBT a long time, and they're going for their first final.
And they're led by Dominic Jones. Dominic Jones, former NBA player, averaging 15 points a game, but also 4 assists and 6 rebounds. He's complemented by maybe the most explosive backcourt in the TBT. Chris Warren, a dynamic offensive player, scored 2,000 points at Ole Miss. And Kenny Morton, a big-time jump shooter. But in the end, Dominic Jones, a dominant physical guard.
A rules overview, a mixture of college, professional FIBA, some NBA. 4 9-minute quarters, 4 timeouts aside. You do get a 6th foul in this before disqualification. And FIBA rule, once that baby hits the rim, you can go get it, except on a free throw attempt. And the elimination, of course, kicks in after each and every game. And it has been such a wonderful addition to TBT and the game of basketball. So much fun, those eliminations. Now, for Florida TNT, this is a club that obviously has played very well. They destroyed the Aftershocks yesterday, 92-63. The Air Force Reserve starters feature Dominic Jones, who we talked about, with Keith Clanton, Kenny Boynton, a scoring machine, of course, Chris Warren, not only in college at Ole Miss, but also in TBT, and Jones to round out the starting five. Boeheim's Army will line up this way. And they've got a lot of talent on the floor with Rice, Malachi Richardson, DJ Kennedy, and DeAndre Kane. A lot of winning tradition from overseas elite to join Boeheim's Army. And Chris McCullough, who has put back-to-back great games together for Boeheim's Army, he may very well, Seth, be the key to their victory today.
I think the key, Chris McCullough's got to get engaged. When I look at Boeheim's Army right now, Tyrese Rice at the start of the game, he's got to play aggressive, he's got to play downhill, he's got to make plays. They can't get into a half-court grinded out game. You're talking about a TNT team that's averaging 85 points a game. Boeheim's Army's got to find a way to get some easy baskets. Look for Rice, look for Kane, look for Kennedy to do some of the dirty work. But McCullough, he's got to be a difference maker up front.
One thing that has marked Boeheim Army's run in this TBT has been their domination on the glass. Do you expect that to continue?
I think they will rebound. I think they've been dominating defensively. And you know what? They're Boeheim's Army. They're dominating defensively, but they're playing man-to-man. They're up and underneath people. They're contested three-point shots. They're creating turnovers. And Jim Boeheim, after the first game, he had a talk with their staff, and he said, you know what? We're better off because we have guys that are outside the family that are better off playing man-to-man.
Ready for game one in our semifinal Sunday, Florida TNT. These guys either are from Florida, played collegiately in Florida, they've gathered to form this team, and playing great. They come out of the Wichita Regional. They beat Everline Drive, the top seed, to get to Dayton. And then yesterday, absolutely massacred the Aftershocks, 92-63. They came out blazing. And you wonder, Seth, that these early starts for pros are a little different. Which team will wake up first?
Yeah, they got a dynamic backcourt. I mean, you think about Jones, you think about Boynton, you think about Warren. Those three guys, they're averaging about 50 points in the TBT. Yesterday, they dropped 60. You've got to run them off the three-point line. The ball pressure of Syracuse will be key, but that backcourt will be hard to contain.
Florida TNT in red and Boeheim's Army in white. We are underway from Dayton, and Chris Warren goes right to work and buries a three.
That's lack of communication. Talk about being ready to play. Jones drops it off. Warren knocks down that jumper, and that's who he is. He's a dynamic scorer.
Boeheim's Army, 6 of 20 on threes in that win over the Golden Eagles. McCullough wide left, and the rebound secured by Dominic Jones.
Dominic Jones in world-class shape, so physical and tough, and that surprising matchup with Rice on Jones.
And he took him right to the hole. Banks it in, 5-0. Kick to the corner, and Richardson. Clayton boards.
You can see a little bounce in this Florida TNT team. And these guys have been over here for about an hour and a half, and they've gotten off to not a good start, but a great start.
McCullough takes the rebound away. Boeheim's Army looking to give the scoreboard company. Kane out of the corner.
Settling to shoot threes right now, Boeheim's Army. I'd like to see them try to attack, get downhill, especially Kane, who can get to the rim, maybe get to the free throw line.
Lob broken up. McCullough. Nice shot, and that breaks the seal for Boeheim's Army.
There's a reason it was a first-round draft choice. You're talking about a 6'11", taking the ball off the defensive glass, attacking, and being on balance on the finish.
Jones. Dunk, follow, no. Clayton kicks it out, and Dominique Jones works it on the wing as we check in with Jen Hale.
Dominique Jones is doing a lot of work right now, Bob, not only on the court, but he gave the pregame speech before Florida TNT came out. It was a rousing one where he told the team, you have to commit to everything you've done to get here to this point. You can't take your foot off the gas. You have to stay committed to all those little details. Clearly, based on the start, it's a message that resonated, Bob.
And the floater by Rice is good after the three ball by Kenny Boynton. It's an 8-4 game.
And Florida TNT, true to their form, coming out, knocking down threes. This is a team that is not a good, but an elite three-point shooting team. You've got to make them drivers. This matchup right here with Jones and DJ Kennedy will be an interesting one.
They seem, Seth, to have a great balance of the outside shooting that you mentioned, but they can also get some buckets in the paint.
Yeah, Clavis does a good job of sealing down low in the dunker spot. They'll play four out with the floor wide open. And they've got a number of what I call floor gamers, guys that can just go and make plays off the bounce.
Kane. And McCullough fouled on the follow. This one on Drew Smith. That will be the first foul of this afternoon's game.
And when Kane gets a mismatch like that, you're going to see him look to post up Warren. That was really nice recognition, but you settle into games. I mean, that's just the way it is. You settle into games, you settle into a game that's going to give you a chance to win $1 million as well.
Hey, listen, sometimes technique off the ball, you bring it up.
The head coach of Boeheim's Army, Jeremy Pope. Diebendorf, sort of in that role of player coach.
Eric Diebendorf's a high basketball IQ. He's done so many good things. He's made Syracuse his home. He's got a number of different initiatives within the community, helping the community, really doing a lot of the work that Coach Boeheim's done. Coach Boeheim has raised so much money for that community and impacted the community with his foundation. And Eric's doing a great job with his own foundation within the Syracuse community.
8-6, Florida TNT after the McCullough free throw. High post and Clanton. Bruce Warren covered up, right back to Clanton. And he takes it inside.
Great job of Warren keeping his dribble alive off that ball screen. Hard roll right there. And that's what Clanton does. He carves out space. He's a big body. He's got very good hands.
Rice. Emblematic of the shot that ended yesterday's game. That little lefty into the lane. That floater goes again, 10-8.
Yeah, talking to Tyrese Rice before this game, he said, you know, he didn't play last year overseas, and he's starting to get his game legs underneath him.
A big body, Keith Clanton. 6'8", 245, and he can use that body.
Bob, if you caught it that deep, you'd score also. You can't let him catch it that deep.
DJ Kennedy, denied. Smith with the block.
How long do they run without it?
Clanton. Off the block, now bangs. Great, come from behind block that time by Kane. Blocked, another block inside. And this one's out of bounds to Florida TNT. Boy, some great interior defense here.
Terrific interior defense. Watch right here on the other end. A great job of Kane getting back into play in transition. McCullough's got to finish that. Terrific weak side help and extra effort by Smith. Smith played at Liberty, won a couple Big South championships.
Chris Warren tried to use the high glass. Boeheim's Army the other way. They were the third seed, winning the Illinois region. Rebound to Jones.
McCullough had a great first game, and he's not shot the ball. He's not shooting the ball confidently. I mean, like, jump up and shoot it like you expect to make it.
Jones. Offensive rebound for Clanton. Back out to Chris Warren. He does it again. You give him just a little bit of room, and he can make you pay.
And I'll tell you, Clanton's carving out space right now. McCullough's got to get much more physical on his blockouts. He's got to do a better job of cutting people out.
15-8, three ball no, and here comes Kenny Boynton, the former Florida standout.
Right now, Boeheim's arm is settling. He's shooting shots early in the clock without moving the ball, moving defense, and Clanton is absolutely dominating the paint.
They're going right back to that matchup with McCullough, trotting up and under. Nothing there. Smith puts it on the deck, and it's poked away by Kane. 8 seconds to shoot when we come back.
Put the ball into the post. If you put the ball in the post, good things happen. The ball comes back out. Warren, an elite three-point shooter, knocks it down. Right now, Florida TNT in good shape. Yeah, sorry, I thought we were going to get the kick out. My bad.
The basketball tournament is presented by Puma Basketball, by E&J Brandy, the official spirit of TBT, and by healthcare IT leaders and Track My Solutions, offering COVID-19 testing and support for schools and businesses. The basketball tournament is presented by Puma Basketball, by E&J Brandy, the official spirit of TBT, and by healthcare IT leaders and Track My Solutions, offering COVID-19 testing and support for schools and businesses. The championship banners courtside here in Dayton, and coming up between games, another interesting twist that TBT brings to basketball, the Puma 33-point contest. You hit 11 threes, you win. There's no clock, and you go head-to-head with an opponent to determine a champion. Can't wait to see this.
It's going to be big time. Connor Frankhoff, Dusty Hand is a terrific shooter from Arkansas. Really going to be interesting, and then Ledbetter at C. But watch Frankhoff. I mean, my man, when he shoots it, you think it's going in every time. But Hattie, he's not a good shooter. He's a great shooter. Obviously, the fan favorite on MR. And it's only as good as your rebounder and passer. You get a good rebounder and passer, you can get up more shots. You get up more shots, who knows? That dude, Mike Dom, he had 30,000 points in college. He's going to be able to make some jumpers.
The Dominator. This is our first time with the three-point contest. We've had the dunk contest in previous years, but I like this twist. These are great shooters.
Yeah, big-time shooters. You talk about three-pointers right now. This is a Florida TNT team that's averaging 43s a game. All right, they've already got three. On the other side, they've been dominating in the paint right now, and they've got a great balance. They've been averaging 34 points a game in the paint, and that's what they've done here. Knockdown threes, and been doing a nice job of getting the ball into the paint. So Boeheim's arm has got to really work. Nice stop right there, getting a shot clock violation.
Now Kiefer Sykes brings it up for Boeheim's Army. He checks in for the first time. Kane for three. And the rebound secured by Brandon Robinson.
One pass, three-point shot's not what you want to do coming out of a timeout.
Boeheim's Army 0 of 6 on threes. And once again, Keith Clanton. He is dominating Boeheim's Army inside.
They've got some tough matchups right now.
Clanton's got 6 rebounds in 6 minutes and now 6 points. Offensive rebound for Kane. Back to Sykes, and this one no good. Overall, Boeheim's Army 3 of 14. Florida TNT 7 of 15. Jones. And he draws the contact. Well, he hit hard, helped up by his teammates.
Clant's been terrific down on the block right there. Look at Clant catching it. A little close off. Inside passing, interior passing, terrific interior passing. Some tough, really tough matchups right now for Boeheim's Army. They're playing the two little guards. They're playing Rice and Sykes. One of those guys has got to guard Jones. Jones at 6'4 and physically strong, can be patient, use his size and strength, and get into the lane, which moves Boeheim's Army in rotation.
An 8-0 run for Florida TNT. Dominic Jones, winning share, $62,500, will be sent with Zell. Member of the Dallas Mavericks championship team back in 2011. He is now 32 years old out of Lake Wales, Florida. Played collegiately at USF. Another missed three. This one by Tyler Lydon.
Another one pass three. Another possession where they're not moving the ball or moving people.
Good hands by Tyler that time, and the reach in on Jones to stop the break.
A couple subs for Boeheim's Army right now. Interesting. C.J. Fair, the ball just finds this guy. C.J. Fair scored 1,700 points in his career at Syracuse. Terrific rebound. He's had a very successful career overseas. And then Andrew White. Andrew White started at Kansas, remember. He transferred to Nebraska, finished up at Syracuse. He is an elite, big-time three-point shooter. You had him with the Hawks for a while.
And my philosophy, Seth, is once a Hawk, always a Hawk. And it was great to catch up with Andrew before the game today. He is a nice young man. Here comes Rice. And they cut off the dribble drive that time, but throw it away on the outlet pass intended for Robinson. We're down Bam's to a minute
Army.
30 in the first quarter.
Yeah, Bam's arm's got to stop settling. They got to move the ball, move people, stop getting off the ball on the bounce, and get the ball reversed. They've settled for three-pointer after three-pointer. I like this post-touch here from Fair. He has the ability to make plays.
Rhythm bounce, and Sykes drains the corner three.
They get a paint touch, and all of a sudden now the defense has to scrape. They get a kick out. Now you shoot a step and three on a ball reversal. Paint touches and ball reversals if you want to get in the game. And then on the other end, you've got to be solid defensive. And we're seeing a little 2-3 zone right here. The first time. Why are they seeing a 2-3 zone? You've got three members of Syracuse on the floor at the same time, especially those backline guys that understand the rotations.
You don't think they've forgotten how to play a 2-3 zone all these years.
Those three guys that have played it haven't, and the key is for the guys up top to be able to get up off and over the top of the screen. The ball cannot get stuck right now, though.
Rice. And the follow, and there's C.J. Fair. He has been dynamite on the glass in TBT for Boeheim's Army.
C.J. Fair is a gamer. C.J. Fair, in a lot of ways, is very similar to what D.J. Kennedy does, but he's found a way to score it.
Really want to rip them on all those screens, but I'm trying to fight my way.
How do you get back in the game? You get paint touches, share the basketball, Sykes on a relocate, good use of the shot fake. Stepping threes are good threes. And then CJ Fair, the ball just finds him. He's an elite offensive rebounder. They've got to get some 50-50 balls. But most importantly, they got to be more efficient offensively. How do you do that? Share the basketball, move the basketball, get some paint touches.
Florida TNT burning a timeout with just 33 seconds to go in the quarter. They can pretty much take this down to the end of the period here on this shot clock.
Look for a high ball screen for Boynton. Nice job on the ball with Sykes. Keep the game in front.
Boynton missing. 1 second. Rice from three-quarter court. Oh, just missed. And the first quarter ends. So a quick start for Florida TNT. They were up 15-8, but Boeheim's Army finally got that first three to go. They cut it back to six. We're at the end of one in Dayton in our first semifinal Sunday matchup.
We should cover the 1-for-10 start from the three. 10 of their one shots from the three.
Be smart about them too. Be smart about them too. Hey, let's get you two in the highs. Let's go uno to a touch, right to a quick. That makes sense? Uno to a touch, Kiefer, right to a quick.
Okay. Let's go together.
One, two, three. Together. So uno to a touch, CJ, right to a quick. You got that, Reese? Uno to a touch, right to a quick.
Hey, Rob. Did they change the score? Should they did on the floor? Okay. Time to look at the road to $1 million set with Zelle. Third seed Boeheim's Army has added some of the most experienced and successful players in TBT history. And one of those players, DJ Kennedy, holds the TBT record for games played and wins as he helped lead Overseas Elite to four championships. Now he hopes to take Boeheim's Army to the promised land and the TBT title in 2021. And if DJ does, he says he will use the money for investing in a family vacation. With COVID, we've spent a lot of time together, so I'm sure we could all use a vacation. And don't forget, each TBT champion will receive their share of that $1 million prize sent with Zelle. Quarter number two about to begin. 19-13 lead for Florida TNT.
All right, gentlemen, here we go.
There is DJ Kennedy. He did a terrific job defensively on Jamil Wilson yesterday. The Golden Eagles held him to 1 of 10 from the field. CJ Fair, another offensive rebound. This one knocked away.
Coming out of that corner, they come out and shoot another three. They're 1 for 10 from the three-point line. They need to start to play downhill, get the ball reversed. That's a set play. It's a play they can run. But when you're trying to get back in the game and get some flow, ball movement, people movement, paint touches are what's going to get others involved. So right now, they can't settle. Like, I look at this lineup right here. They've got to try to find some maybe flat ball screens or some ball reversals and drive some closeouts. I do like Fair getting touches.
Fair, proud member of Team Lefty, with a nice turnaround.
C.J. Fair can score. He keeps balls alive. He kept that possession alive by getting to the glass. He's a guy that's got to play this game. And you notice the whole back line of this zone, Leiden, Fair, and White are all Syracuse players that understand how high they've got to come up in the zone offense and the defense.
Boynton steals the offensive rebound. Back to Jones.
And there's guards not coming back and rebounding because they don't understand the importance of coming back and rebounding in the zone. Well, you got two guys right there that aren't zone players that are non-Syracuse alums.
They fronted Fair. Now they get it to him. And a soft touch.
Every time they've gotten a paint touch, every time they've actually moved the ball, they've gotten a good shot. And they found a little weakness. Now watch Florida TNT. They're going to go double the post. How they play out of those doubles will be key. You see the two guards. You get the little guards up front type with Sykes and Rice. Both of those guys have got to come back and get back to the elbows and help rebound the ball.
Coming up later tonight, Sunday Night Baseball matches the Red Sox against the Rays. Game time is 7 Eastern on ESPN, ESPN Deportes, and the ESPN app. Coverage begins a half hour earlier than usual this evening, 5:30 Eastern, with Baseball Tonight Sunday Night Countdown.
Watch out for those Yankees. Now you got four Syracuse players on the floor. Notice you're a little bit bigger at the top with the guards. White has the ability to come back and rebound the ball.
Brandon Robinson knocks down the three. And I saw how you snuck in the Yankee reference.
Yeah, like the Yankees are on a little bit of a roll right now. I don't want to say anything.
Well, you just did. Leiden goes in. And there to clear it up is Clanton.
Leiden, the first-round draft choice of the Denver Nuggets. He's got to be more productive. Did a good job rebounding the ball yesterday. 8 rebounds in about 12 minutes, but he's got to give him a little bit of offense.
And another three. Brandon Robinson's heating up.
And this backcourt is hard. You've got to make him put it down. You cannot close short right now in the zone. You've got to have better pressure on the ball.
Richardson. Nice. Malachi Richardson. He had 9 yesterday against the Golden Eagles in 23 minutes. Hit a couple of threes and had 7 rebounds. Robinson. Some contact, but no whistle. Picked off by Jones. No. Fair gets it back. And then he's fouled on the drive. Tristan Spurlock commits the personal.
I like the idea of playing zone. The last possession in zone, you saw the forwards. The thing that makes the Syracuse zone different is how high those forwards play up. They've got to be active, and the guards have got to be able to get over the screens. Let's see if the ball gets reversed and we get some movement here.
With the left hand, Kiefer Sykes coming up a little bit short. It remains 27-19 as Jones, that big body in a huge mismatch out front when they do have to guard them in single coverage. Clanton, kicking it back. Robinson the fake. Robinson the fire, and he's got his third three.
That's 3 threes coming off the bench. Good patience, and Clanton's very good passer. Very patient. Robinson really patient using his shot fake.
30-19. DeAndre Kane.
And that's good basketball for DeAndre Kane. DeAndre Kane's not a three-point shooter, but he's a scorer, and he's a physical defender and a rebounder. And they've got to play more downhill on ball reversals with Kane getting downhill. You're talking about a guy who started at Marshall, transferred to Iowa State, a terrific player, led Iowa State, and one of the leaders in assists, actually, in the Big 12. And
Clanton's just
kicking their tail right now. He gets the ball anywhere he wants, anytime he wants. He gets body, and he gets angles. Terrific job. They've got to defend him earlier.
8-8 in the first half for Clanton. Lob to Leiden, and he rolls it in. That took a victory lap and dropped in.
Leiden, nice catch right there and finish. He's got to defend on the other end. You can't let post people just catch it anywhere they want with 2 feet in the paint.
Robinson draws an immediate double team as hot as he's been. Boynton lets it fly. And once again, Clem inside, but despite inside position, Syracuse gets the basketball as Kane has it on the baseline. Good save. Kiefer to the hole. No. Gets his own miss. Sykes kicks it out. Richardson. Here's one way to beat the zone. In transition. No call. It's out of bounds to Florida TNT. Dominique with a look of disbelief. We've got a timeout, 3:52 to go, second quarter. Florida TNT up on Boeheim's Army.
What are we missing here, Rob? Gates in like a doldrum a little bit.
Boeheim's Army settled on shooting a three, but you got to make the three. Starting off the game, they are 1-for-12 from the three-point line. They got to play more downhill. Quality of shot, shooting it early on the first side, not moving the ball, not moving the defense, and the wrong guys sometimes shooting those threes. Not only, look, they can make threes, but they got quality of shots. On the other side, you're talking about Florida TNT. They're 6-for-9 from the three-point line. Oh, by the way, they have 6 assists compared to only 2 from Boeheim's Army. They're getting them on ball movement and using the shot fake. Their ability to use the shot fake right there to Robinson to create a little space. He's 3-for-3 from the three. And this is the DNA of this Florida TNT team. High volume of three-point shooting, guard-oriented, and they've really done a nice job of sharing the basketball and making plays.
Brandon Robinson played at Clayton State. This is his 5th appearance in TBT. Last year, overseas in Argentina. But he can explode, did it in the fourth quarter against that Eberline Drive top seed. He had 13 points in the fourth quarter. Here's what's coming up at 2 p.m. Eastern time here on ESPN, the Puma 33-point contest. Then semifinal game number 2, matching Team 23 against Blue Collar U. The championship game, 9 o'clock Eastern, Tuesday night here from Dayton. Nothing doing for Smith. Boeheim's Army the other way. McCullough back in. And how about that D by Robinson? And out of bounds to Florida TNT.
They get the ball to the post. McCullough's got to finish that, or he's got to find. Look at CJ Fair in the TBT area. When McCullough catches the ball, you'll see Fair right there diving. That's got to be a post-to-post pass. Back in that zone, they've got to do a better job of locating Robinson, and then when the ball goes to that mid-post, they've got to locate people behind the defense.
Yeah. for a lock, right to the hole.
That's just unacceptable. On that reversal, he just drove the close out by C.J. Fair, got to the front of the rim to his strong hand. That can't happen.
Robinson with the foul on the Rice drive. Let's check in with Jen.
Well, Bob, waiting for this zone D to really kick in, but you and Seth were talking about how difficult it could be for the new pieces, the non-Syracuse guys, to master that zone D. How about a brand new head coach, Jeremy Pope? He's not from Syracuse either, but Eric Diedendorf handpicked him for this role because of his experience with the zone. He was an assistant coach under Mike Hopkins. He was responsible for cutting up all the film, all the scouting, did all the breakdowns, so he feels like he really learned Hopkins' revamped version of Boeheim zone, and he's hoping they'll pull it off now. And an added little bonus, former head coach Ryan Blackwell, he's still here. He's on the bench. He's helping Pope at anything he needs. He has a new daughter, 2 months old, so that's why he's not in the head coaching role now. Congratulations to Ryan and his wife, guys.
Indeed. 10-point game, and McCullough takes it to the rim and cuts it to 8.
And they switch back to the man-to-man that last possession. Look, when you're playing with guys that really don't understand the intricacies of the zone, I don't care how well you're teaching it. In 1 week, you're not going to learn it. What they've got to do right now is they've got to get up and into people and be more aggressive defensively.
Rice gets over the screen. Chris Warren tees up Spurlock, and he is a little long with that three ball. And that's really been the story. Florida TNT has hit 6 out of 10. Boeheim's Army's 1 of 12. Rice will drive and kick. Richardson. No love of the rim.
I look at Boeheim's Army. They got to get some stops and they got to play faster. If they get stuck in the half court, the ball's getting stuck. If they get a clean stop, they got to get out in transition, and then attack.
We've got a timeout. 2:02 to go in the first half. TNT by 8.
Clay has been a dominant force in this game. Big body, terrific hands, has the ability to finish around the basket, and an excellent inside-out passer, but they have not been able to keep him out of the paint. Look how patient he is getting to the middle of the floor and creating angles. Right there, catch, close off, finish. He keeps it simple, but most importantly, he knows exactly who he is. He's going to play block to block and in the dunker spot, not going to dunk it, but what he's going to do is rebound the ball, close out around the basket.
Chris McCullough. Through all the trials and tribulations, Seth, Boeheim's Army's only down 6.
Yeah, Chris McCullough, back-to-back interior baskets. He's got to be more aggressive. Don't settle to shoot threes. Pound that thing inside. Get the ball reverse. Get paint touches. And then in this end, double Clint. You got to get the ball out of his hands.
And double they did with Fair. 13 on the shot clock.
Clanton is so patient. Now, he's a very good passer, but they've got to get the ball out of his hands. And if you double, you got to double him aggressively so he can't turn his shoulders.
Warren. Rebound C.J. Fair.
They need to run right now. Push and attack.
Rice, a pull-up three. Nothing but net. Tyrese Rice cuts it to 3. 8 unanswered for Boeheim's Army. And a steal. Kane takes it in on Jones. Too strong, Clanton the rebound. And Kane is hurt at the other end. And we've got a foul coming on Boeheim's Army.
Kane looks like he rolled his ankle right there as he came down. And they need his toughness right here. Great job defensively. We talk about pressuring the basketball. He didn't roll it on someone's foot. He came down in a bad way. And then Rice just in transition, pulling up and knocking down. The more pressure and the later in the game, the better Rice plays. But right now, defensive pressure is really important. Great play, weak side flare screen right there. Play fast.
Missed the shot. Here's Rice. Boeheim's Army on this 8-0 run.
They got to space the floor. They're going to put McCullough in ball screens. Give them room to run to the rim. There it is.
And a nice pass finds Chris McCullough on the cut, and it's a one-point game.
You get that place in the shot as long as that net. That was really good offense right there. They opened up the floor, that middle ball screen with McCullough. If you tag it, you kick it out. You got an open three. If you don't tag it, he runs to the rim and gets an easy layup.
Dominique Jones after 18 yesterday against the Aftershocks. Can't connect. Florida TNT's lost their offensive rhythm, and it's out of bounds to Boeheim's Army.
Down the other end, this is really good offense, right? Middle ball screen, watch how spread the floor is. Everyone's outside the three-point line. If you tag it, all right, you can take it away, but if you don't tag it, McCullough goes right to the rim. I would expect they go right back to some type of high ball screen action with the court spread. Look for Florida TNT to help off of Fair, who's now going through the lane, defended by Clanton, number 33.
Shot clock is off. Rice pops out. Clanton, 2 seconds. Boynton got it off in time, and it just popped out. That would have counted had it gone. Great half. Florida TNT jumped out early. The second quarter belongs to Boeheim's Army, and we've got a one-point game. 34-33 here at the half. Let's go to Jen.
Thanks, guys. Here with Coach Iron Rainey. Coach, red-hot start for your squad, but you seem to lose some sort of offensive rhythm there at the end and allowed Boeheim's Army to eat into this lead. What happened? How did that unfold?
Absolutely. We got a little lax. I think our guys came out. We didn't execute the same way we did in the first quarter. Going back in the locker room, I'll talk to my guys about that, and we're going to go back to committing to what got us here in the first place.
Committing. And Dominique Jones talked a lot about that pregame, didn't he?
Absolutely. He did talk a lot about that. Our team has been preparing for a long time to get to this place, and I think now, because we're playing against a tough Syracuse team, we just kind of got a little bit lax and got away from what we were doing before. So once again, I'm going back to the locker room to talk to our guys about getting to exactly what got us here in the first place.
Thanks, Coach. Best of luck.
Yep, thank you.
Bob.
Thank you, Jen. Boeheim's Army scratching back, much like they did yesterday against the Golden Eagles. They were down early in that game and then finally put a rally together to take over in the Elam ending and win.
They didn't settle. They played in transition. They got more aggressive defensively. The ditch zone got up and underneath the basketball, created some turnovers. McCullough gave them good minutes. Rice gave them good minutes. And C.J. Fair must be on the court if Syracuse is going to win this game.
Halftime. And when we come back, we'll check in with Dayton head coach Anthony Grant. Stay with us.
Missing anything?
It is a one-point game here in Dayton. We are now in your halftime report brought to you by the Air Force Reserve. A fantastic day of hoops action here at the basketball tournament, the $1 million winner-take-all summer hoops tradition. Besides the games, we also have a fabulous 33-point contest coming up for you shortly. But right now, we want to welcome in a very special guest, Coach Anthony Grant, the head coach here at Dayton for the men's basketball team. Coach, we love being here. This arena is so beautiful. Dayton has been so incredibly welcoming. What does it mean to this school and this community to have a TBT team and then to be a host for the finals?
Well, Jen, it's great to have basketball here. You know, this is a community that really loves basketball. Obviously, they love the Dayton Flyers, you know, so we obviously were hoping that our team would be in it, the Red Scare, but unfortunately, they weren't able to make it. But I think just having basketball here at this time of year, the fans enjoy coming out watching it, and actually, a lot of these guys, I remember I recruited some of them, I watched some of them play, so having a chance to come out and see them right now, either playing for their university or playing for some causes, obviously, that are near and dear to a lot of people, it's great to have it here.
That Red Scare put up a great fight in Columbus. We were sorry to not see them advance either. You do have a player, though, in the 33-point contest coming up here in just a little bit, Jordan Seibert. He didn't get to play for you. You guys missed each other, but he's a young man you're well familiar with.
Yeah, Jordan's terrific. You know, he's been a guy that comes around, spends time with our players, has gotten to know all of our coaches. You know, he's right up the road there in Cincinnati. He's had a great career since he left Dayton, and obviously the Dayton fans remember all the memorable shots that he made here as a Flyer, some of the great memories in the history of our program. Jordan was a big part of that. So we're excited to see him have a chance to make some money here today, and we'll be rooting him on.
Absolutely. It's going to be fun to watch. It's 11 shots, first one to 11, and in the best time. So that's going to be a fun competition. Okay, Coach, you are a busy man. You've been hitting the recruiting trail hard. Give us a little insight into what your Flyer squad is going to look like this year.
Yeah, well, we're excited about the group we have. It's a new team, you know, so for our fans, they're going to have to learn some of the new guys that we have, a lot of new faces. And obviously last year with COVID, we didn't have an atmosphere here in the building. So it'll be great, hopefully, to have the fans back, for them to get to know our players. I know our guys are working really hard. They're excited about the upcoming year.
No one will ever forget that 18-0 run, and you well-deserving of that Head Coach of the Year award, and we just wish we could have seen you play for a whole championship that year.
Well, I appreciate it. Like I always say, we're grateful for what we did, get a chance to be a part of that year. It was a special group, and the plan now is to go ahead and make some more memories.
Absolutely. Coach, thanks so much for your time. We certainly appreciate it.
I appreciate it, Jim.
This was your halftime report brought to you by the Air Force Reserves. We are back with the second half of action in just a moment. So keep it right here on ESPN. TBT is back in just a moment.
Hey, Clanton, we should Clanton 8-10 would be really good. And then on the other end, I think that CJ Fair got it going a little bit for them. Oh, all right, good, all right. Thank you.
The basketball tournament is presented by Puma Basketball and by Air Force Reserve. Explore your opportunities with Air Force Reserve. The basketball tournament is presented by Puma Basketball and by Air Force Reserve. Explore your opportunities with Air Force Reserve. Tuesday night, 9 o'clock Eastern. Make a date to join us here on ESPN for the championship game. Semifinal Sunday continues. We begin the third quarter with TNT leading Boeheim's Army by one. Bob Rathbun and Seth Greenberg back with you. It's amazing, Seth, how the game of basketball has changed. Everything nowadays revolves around the three-point shot.
And the start of the game, Florida TNT, they knocked down six threes early. All of a sudden, that Boeheim's Army, a little bit better ball pressure, all of a sudden creating some offense out of the defense. And then offensively, they did a better job of playing downhill, getting paint touches, being a little bit more disciplined offensively. They've got to find a solution, though, for Keith Clanton. 8 points, 10 rebounds, and been dominated, carving out space in the lane.
What'd you think of the zone they went to, Syracuse?
I didn't think it was very good. That's not who they are. They got too many guys that didn't play for Syracuse to play the zone. To play that zone, you've got to have five guys connected and understand the forward's got to be up, and those guards have got to be come back and rebound the ball. You have inexperienced guards there, and it's going to be tough. And look, the numbers have balanced off, except Boeheim's Army should not be shooting 13 threes. They've got to get more paint touches, drive the ball, get the ball in reverse, get it to Fair, get it to McCullough, and then points off turnovers. That was the ball pressure late in the game that got them back in the game.
Let's send it over to Jen.
Well, Bob, to Seth's point, I just finished talking with Boeheim's Army coach Jeremy Pope, and he says they have got to share the ball more, get that ball moving. Good things happen when the ball moves instead of sticking. So much like Seth was pointing out in the first half, Jeremy really got into his team at halftime about ISO shots, taking your first opportunity. Stay away from that type of lazy basketball. A little bit better energy, a little more commitment, speaking of that word, to moving the ball, and he thinks that'll really help Boeheim's Army get going.
A second half to determine a championship finalist on Tuesday night. Florida TNT in red, Boeheim's Army in white, and there he is again, Keith Clanton.
And good job, Florida TNT. They got the switch. They got Kennedy on Clanton. Clanton extremely patient. If you get a small on big on the post, you got to double, get the ball out of his hands. You can't let him back his man down. And now all of a sudden, right just at the start of the second half, he's already got a double-double.
Had one against L.A. earlier in this tournament. I love his patience. You know, he's 33 years old, Seth. He's seen it all, the post.
Yeah, he's an experienced player with a big body, really good hands, and he doesn't settle. This is a good matchup for Boeheim's Army right there. Drive it. There we go. That's better basketball.
Good to see DeAndre Kane back out there after the little ankle twist to that left foot. 36-33, Florida TNT.
Better possession right there. This is about getting up and under people, getting pressure, creating some easy offense. There's another tough matchup for Clanton right there.
They try to lob it, and it's out of bounds.
Malachi Richardson, he missed that shot. He's got to just step up and shoot the basketball in possession before. He can't think you're going to miss shots. Basketball's not a game of perfect, but you've got to get to the next play a lot quicker than he's getting there.
Kennedy back irons. This one is going to be tipped to the wing and saved by Boynton.
And that's not his game. Plain and simple, that's not his game. So you take a quick three on the first side, and what happens? TNT runs it right back at him, and they get to the line.
Well, speaking of Richardson, yesterday he started 0 for 4 in that game and then finally warmed up against the Golden Eagles, and hoping that for Boeheim's Army's sake that he can find the range one more time. Dominique to the line, and Jones' winning share will be sent with Zell. As Florida TNT leads it by four, winning share of 62,500. Second shot. And McCullough up there to get it. The free throw shooting in TBT kind of comes and goes with some of these teams. Rice lost the handle. Good pressure.
That's right, stop being strong with the basketball. Clanton steps out on the ball screen. All right, you've either got to turn the corner or back dribble and throw it back. Rice just a little loose with the basketball. Bad start right now for Boeheim's Army.
4-point lead for TNT. Boynton hikes it up and knocks it down.
Very similar start in the second half that they did the first half. You can't go underneath the screen. Boynton shoot 41% from the three-point line. Then handoff, you go underneath Tyrese Rice, and that's going to be a turnover. I don't like the energy. I don't like the body language of Boeheim's Army. Very slow to get an offense. Ball's getting stuck. That's another settled three. That is not a good shot. Plain and simple, that's not a good shot.
And now the ball was touched. So Boeheim's Army gets a break.
And on the other side, watch right here. Watch Tyrese Rice. He goes under that handoff. He gets buried by Clanton. And you know what? Boynton's going to knock down that shot. He's a 41% three-point shooter.
McCullough choked off by Clanton at the foul line. Kennedy coughs it up. Jones one hands it through. Drew Smith it out of bounds.
You look at Boeheim's Army right now, they've got to do whatever they do. Whatever best set they have, they've got to run right now. But it surely can't be on the first side. They've got to find a way to get the ball reversed and attack and close out and make a play.
And a timeout coming for Boeheim's Army. They are overall 2 of 17 on threes.
2 of 17, but look, I love DJ Kennedy, but he can't be settled on first side three-point shots. He's got to be an attacking, aggressive player. Tyrese Rice, he can't turn the ball over early in the half. He can't go underneath the ball screen.
Let's listen in. In the huddle, brought to you by Puma Basketball. Here's the difference between first half, second half, slow starts. You got that Elam ending coming around the corner. You do not, and really you cannot, be buried early in this third quarter.
Right now, the great thing about Boeheim's Army is they hold each other accountable. You know, obviously Jeremy is their coach, but this is a group of guys that have been together. You talk about DJ Kennedy, DeAndre Kane. They went to high school together at Chinle High. They hold each other accountable, and that's right now what they need to do.
Jones takes care of the McCullough miss. Once again, the momentum swinging toward Florida TNT. Jones facilitates out to Boynton. Now Chris Warren. Clanton has been so effective. Look at this fake. Missed the shot, but saves it. Another opportunity for TNT.
Clanton is so patient. You got to body him, wall up, and not let him get to the paint, or you got to scrape and dig the ball out.
Smith on the reverse, and Clanton is there to take it away. Boy, he's impressive. Boynton with two on the clock. Rice.
And that's that's a good thing. They've got to play fast. If you get a clean stop, you got to play fast. You got to play ahead of the defense. That's a nice job of DeAndre Kane getting an early post up and Rice advance passing it. The slower Rice plays, the better it is for TNT. The faster they play early in the clock, in terms of playing aggressive, playing downhill, and you see Tyler Lydon coming into the game. Why? Because McCullough was not rebounding the basketball. He was not defending early. Now, Lydon didn't do that in the first half either. So this is going to be a very interesting sub. But Boeheim's Army has got to draw a line in the sand and compete. I always say the hardest playing, toughest team finds a way to win. Right now, that's Florida TNT. Boeheim's Army, they have not competed at the level you need to compete at to win this $1 million.
Way over the top to Kane. Hits! Big shot for DeAndre Kane. Brings that winning mentality from overseas elite to Boeheim's Army.
And this is a better matchup. Kane on Jones, the ability to use a little bit of size and strength to keep him out of the lane.
Andrew Smith gets the love of the rim. 43-36. Anthony Grant has installed some soft rims here at Dayton. Leiden, right to the hole.
Good job right back, dribbling to create that angle. Now Leiden's got to do something down this end. Smith can shoot the basketball. He's got to help on these screens, but he's also got to do a good job of getting out the three-point shooters. And Kenny Boynton, who Anthony Grant recruited to Florida.
That's exactly right.
And went to multiple Elite Eights.
When he was Billy Donovan's assistant. Tyler Leiden missing the three. Rebound to Dominique Jones. Florida TNT up seven.
Big possession right here. Got to keep the ball out of the lane. Got to get a clean stop and see if he can get out in transition.
Kenny missing. Rice, what happened? A wet spot, and Rice points to it. They'll try to clean that up with the teams at the other end.
Watch 11 Smith doing a great job on these ball screens.
Tyler Leiden inside again. So they go to the big man, the 6'9", former Syracuse star on their Final Four team with Malachi Richardson. 45-40. That one hit the side of the glass by Robinson. Loose ball, TNT gets it back. Kenny Boynton tees up Spurlock, the fake. Opposite corner to Richardson, Robinson rather. He was hot in that first half. Forced up a three and deep in the corner that time.
Spurlock is a really good defender, just a really good complimentary player. Ball can't get stuck.
Sykes. Good closeout by Jones. Tyler Leiden, nope. Rebound out to C.J. Fair.
Farrell.
He is a ball magnet,
yeah,
isn't he?
Yeah, he is. The ball just fell. He'll back his man down, try to get a foul here.
Stripped away. Keith Clanton with the D.
Multiple possessions with a chance to knock it down to three or two. They come up empty.
And we've got a foul coming on Kiefer Sykes.
Tyrese Rice, if you could have trapped the ball screen, why do you come off a ball screen to basically force two to play? He draws two, reads the defense, looks off the wing, and makes the play. They need more of that. Unselfish, solid basketball with good spacing.
We got to keep rebounding the basketball, staying patient on offense. Okay, keep rebounding the basketball, staying patient on offense. Let's execute. You good? Don't worry about it. Don't worry about it. So let's keep digging. Let's keep digging. Keep digging. That's what got us here. Big stops, easy buckets. Big stops, easy baskets.
I got you. Big stops.
What I was saying on that, saying, look, yeah. Look, so even listen to me.
Okay.
Even if you can't shoot, right?
No.
But I maybe made one or two, I still want you to make him respect it. Here.
Yeah, like what?
No, but when
before he shoots?
Before he shoots.
Because then I can't move sideways.
Listen to me. He's going to the basket, so it's already a short closeout.
Yeah.
Short closeout, high hands,
okay.
And then make him think about it. Okay. That way he's not comfortable winding up getting into a shot. Right. Just throw his rhythm off.
Yeah, I got you.
Yes, sir. Got to rotate, fellas. Rotation is important. Rotation is extremely important. Let's go.
Let's go. Dominate on three.
Dominate.
One, two, three.
Dominate. Hey, B, good defense. Good defense. We got to keep rebounding the basketball, staying patient on offense. Okay, keep rebounding the basketball, staying patient on offense. Hey, we got to keep rebounding the basketball, staying patient on offense. Okay, keep rebounding the basketball, staying patient on offense. Let's execute. You good. Don't worry about it. Don't worry about it. So let's keep digging. Let's keep digging. Keep digging. That's what got us here. Big stops, easy buckets. Big stops, easy baskets.
I got you. Big stops.
What I was saying on that.
Like, we can't be too emotional. You can have emotions, but we can't be over-emotional about it.
Say your piece and be over it. Come on, man. Together on three. One, two, three.
Yeah, it's a really good job of both coaches doing a nice job. And what happened is our Florida TNT, they just want to get stops, rebound, play ahead of the defense, and play just good, solid basketball. And on the other end, you know, this is an emotional team, Boeheim's Army. They brought those three guys on to bring that toughness, that emotion, that energy. You know what? It's called tough love, but they hold each other accountable. So you've got to be emotional, but you've got to stay in the moment. And that's the most important thing. Be emotional, but stay in the moment.
Boeheim's Army has not yet led in this game. They have had one other time in their TBT history where they've made it to the semifinals, but all in all, it's been a pretty frustrating existence for the men representing Syracuse in this event.
And that's why they brought these three guys on. They brought these three guys on to win a winning pedigree. You're talking about, you know, DJ Kennedy, four championships. You're talking about DeAndre Kane, three championships. Kiefer Sykes is a winning player. Really nice job defensively on the ball.
Warren kept alive for an instant by Clanton. The ball belongs to Boeheim's Army, and Rice will lay it in. It's a three-point game.
It's a three-point game, and that's the way they need to play. They need to play out in transition. They need to play off of that pressure defense, trying to get up and under TNT to push them out and speed them up offensively.
Seth, if you're Boeheim's Army, you got to be feeling pretty good about this. You haven't played all that well. You can't hit a three, and it's only a three-point deficit.
Can't hit a three, but you better rebound the ball, and you better find a way to defend Clanton on dribble penetration. There he is again.
Unstoppable inside today. Keith Clanton.
And that was a poor job of containing the ball, but his ability to create passing lanes, what I call getting in windows, he does a great job of getting in windows. Another good job in ball screen defense.
CJ Fair up top, now over to Rice. Just a minute 18 left in the third.
You see they committing to every ball screen. They're doing a good job of committing to Rice.
Brandon Robinson with the rebound, brings it down himself. Robinson trying to size up CJ Fair, and that's a very difficult shot, but another offensive rebound, and Boynton misses. It remains a five-point spread.
They're going to try to go two for one right here if they can, and they got to be a little tighter with their handles. They still have time. Quick high ball screen. Might as well get a good shot now.
Fair, that's going to be a travel.
Just a bad possession right there. I mean, just an empty possession that you can't have. Big possession right here. I would think TNT is going to take the last shot. You need to get a stop because, like you said, Bob, you want to keep it within striking distance when you get to the elim ending. The other thing we got to keep a track on right now is fouls, all right? Boeheim's Army has two total fouls. Obviously, TNT only has one. Getting into the bonus early in the elim ending is really important because it's one shot and the basketball.
Dominique Jones has scored seven today. He's got six boards and four assists. Now some pressure by DeAndre Kane. And a strip by Kane. 7 seconds, six. They do end up with a two for one, and Warren with a wise foul.
A really good foul, but a foul that gets you closer in the elim ending potentially to the bonus. Now, we haven't seen Eric Diebendorf in this game at all, but look at Kane. Turn, sprint, great hands on the ball, and now they get a chance to get out in transition.
Side out of bounds here with a little over 4 seconds. Warren went for the steal, loose ball. They're not going to get a shot away, and they do. Right at the horn, but another missed opportunity for Syracuse alums.
But they're in striking distance. They're going to start with the ball at the start of the fourth quarter, which will be really important to get a chance to cut it to 3 points. And they've just got to have better offensive possessions.
We're at the end of three. The elim ending is right around the corner. One of these teams will keep their million-dollar hopes alive. TNT up five.
Thank you.
stretch it up. Chris, come stretch it. Kiefer, stretch it. Chris, go get Reese. Open it up. Quick return. Chris, go get Reese. Touch it up. Chris, come stretch it. Kiefer, stretch it. Chris, go get Reese. Open it up. Look at the turn.
Hey, when you dragging off the screens, I'm wide open, bro. Hey, dog. Everywhere, I'm moving with you. Wherever you go, I'm coming. You go this way, I'm coming. My nigga's helping all the way down here, man. Just letting y'all know. I saw the whole ball. No, you good. You good, I'm just letting you know.
Hey, we got to find the energy and the effort to keep contesting. They missing something, they bailing us out. But we gotta find the energy and the effort to keep contesting and keep fighting. We gotta rebound, we have to rebound. Let's go.
Yeah, Coach Pope, first of all, this side out of bounds, but they're gonna try to get Tyrese Rice coming off a stagger screen back to the ball for a three. And you know, you hear these guys, they're holding each other accountable. They gotta get effort, but they also have to be better with the basketball. Tyrese Rice has gotta be better with the basketball. And it'll be interesting to see how they use DJ Kennedy. They brought DJ Kennedy into this thing for winning time. He's really struggled today. They need him to have an impact on this game down the stretch.
Let's send it over to Jen.
Well, Bob, DJ Kennedy was not coming to Boeheim's Army without DeAndre Kane. They were a package deal that was part of the arrangement, that was part of what sold DJ on coming to BA. He said, only if I can bring Kane. And when you watch Kane out on the court, he's taking a little breather right now, but man, he has been such a fabulous communicator. He has brought the energy, even if the rest of the team hasn't followed suit. He's been encouraging his teammates, communicating. This means so much to him. It's so personal. He's such an intense player. The whole team needs to get more of that fire and spark to close this one out if they want to make up ground, guys.
DJ Kennedy and DeAndre Kane went to high school together. They won a high school state championship at Chinle High School. And they won on toughness and they won on effort. And that's who they are.
Well, there's a big stick back by Chris McCullough. And he'll go to the line for one free throw.
And I like that they didn't settle. Watch the curl right there by Rice. McCullough doing a good job of getting into a window and staying with the play. It's a two-point game potentially. All right, coming into the fourth quarter. Right now, quality possessions, pressure in the basketball. On the other end, TNT, they got to move the ball a little bit more. The pressure on the basketball has had an impact on TNT's offensive flow.
Chris McCullough has led Boeheim's Army in scoring today with 14 points. It's a 47-45 game.
How do you defend Clanton? Do you dig? Do you scrape?
Boy, nice quick spin and lays it in. He's abused McCullough in the post.
They've got to get the ball out of his hands. They've got to go. As soon as he puts it on the ground, they got to go double and make him spray that thing out.
We play to the Elam ending. And that comes along, first dead ball under the four-minute mark on the fourth quarter game clock. Rice poked away by Boynton.
Boynton's been really good pressuring the basketball, uses his reach, and that's just a bad shot. That's an empty possession and a bad shot. You can't get in a one-on-one battle with someone. You got to move the ball, move people, and get others involved offensively. I like this, a little push right here. Good
Good hands by Boynton. He's been a difference maker.
He's averaging two steals a game. He is so active defensively with his hands getting deflections.
Sunday Night Baseball tonight, the Red Sox and Rays. Game time is at 7 p.m. Eastern on ESPN, ESPN Deportes, and the ESPN app. Baseball tonight, Sunday Night Countdown, a half hour earlier than usual at 5:30 Eastern time. But plenty of basketball until we get you to baseball here on ESPN. This is game one of our doubleheader with the 33-point contest coming up at 2 Eastern. Clanton, mid-floor to Jones, a four-point Florida TNT lead. Poked away by Kane, and it's out of bounds to Boeheim's Army.
Kane's had a number of deflections getting up and underneath and pressuring the basketball.
Coach Rainey and Florida TNT not thrilled with that call.
The best way to guard Clanton is to pressure the ball. Ball pressure buys time and forces bigs to repost. They've got to put as much pressure as they can on the basketball.
McCullough, good. Boeheim's Army within two. Florida TNT has led the entire afternoon. Dominic Jones.
And that's the first time they scraped down off the post pass and got the ball out of Clanton's hands.
DJ Kennedy back out to Tyrese Rice. A diagonal pass, a dangerous one at times. And this time, Brandon Robinson knocked it away. 6:29 on the game clock. Elam ending in 2:29. McCullough. And for the first time, Boeheim's Army takes the lead.
You talk about winning plays. You see McCullough knock down that three, but it was the screen by Kane that freed him up. Terrific screen by DeAndre Kane.
And Kane with the pressure helped force that turnover. It's going to be a foul.
Interesting this foul is called because yesterday we had a similar play and it was a loose ball. But you saw the screen by Kane on the upper right-hand side of your screen. And that was just a big, big-time screen that freed up McCullough.
First team foul on Boeheim's Army. It is charged to DeAndre Kane. That's only the fifth foul that's been called the entire game on Boeheim's Army. Dominic Jones to play it in. 2:10 before the Elam ending.
Where are you doubling from? You got to double. Where are you doubling from? Someone's got to go.
Clanton just hooks it in. He took all day and very patiently scored.
And he's real patient. As soon as he puts it on the ground, you got to get the ball out of his hands.
And a steal by Chris Warren. Boynton alone lays it in, and TNT goes up by three. What a play by Chris Warren. You talk about quickness. Kane to the hole. That rolls off. Tip no good. Clanton secures. A minute 20 before the Elam ending.
Big defensive possession right here.
Keith Clanton, what a game. 16 points, 16 boards. Now, Dominic Jones moving in, moving out.
You got Kane on the lower left-hand side of your screen matched up with Clanton. Watch him when the ball goes up on the glass. Can he cut him out and keep him off the glass?
Warren had to shoot at the end of the clock and banks it a three. Oh, my. Florida TNT by six. Rice. He'll shoot two. Let's take a look at our hustle play. Brought to you by E&J Brandy. Nice behind the back out of the double team. And then the banked in three. Be sure to visit E&J's website to watch the Hustle series featuring TBT teams and players. Tyrese Rice knocks down the first free throw. to make it 56-51. Now, Seth, the Elam ending strategy starts to come into play here with clock management with 4:43 for Florida TNT.
Yeah, Florida TNT wants a good, solid possession, and because they haven't committed a ton of fouls, all right, they can, if the game, the clock goes under 4 minutes, they can give a foul and not be in the bonus, which wouldn't be the worst thing to get into the Elam ending, especially with a significant lead.
Up by five, Boynton, and there is McCullough on the back of Clanton. Second team foul on Boeheim's Army.
They've had no answer for Clanton this whole game. He catches it, he's patient in the post. All right, right there, you come over the back. You gotta do your work early. You're defending the post at any level. You gotta do your work early.
Boynton. He'll take the three and miss the three. Boeheim's Army running with Kennedy. Big bucket as that produces the lead to three. Now Florida TNT, will they try to score? Will they call a timeout under four? Let's see.
I would think they'd call a timeout.
Well, they got Boynton and he gets fouled. So Kenny Boynton will go to the foul line and a chance to get to 58 points and then set the target score. But the free throws will come before we get to the Elam ending. Kenny Boynton with the lane vacated. Florida TNT, their team share, and they win it on Tuesday night. That's how they'll divvy up the $1 million prize sent with Zell.
And I love the teams that split it right down the middle. I mean, they're in this thing together. They've been working towards this goal. No one's more important than anyone else. I think that's the way this needs to be done. And now they're in terrific shape as we set the target score in the last 4 minutes.
And 8 points to Florida TNT's total. The target score has been established. They'll play to that number when we come back after this.
No rhythm and flow. Hopefully get it in the year mentor.
I just want him to see you.
Okay, I'm gonna say the big is like screening, so he's like in between. Boston, I'm fighting for him. So
hey, you gotta front as soon as you can.
Hey, whoever got the four man, if you got that four man, you can stay a little bit, but I gotta go to him. I can't leave
Hey, but you two, whoever this is, gotta watch these. You gotta watch those. Uno quick to a touch. We gotta keep the big dude in the mix.
We gotta get 66 now. Come on.
Stops the layup.
This is what matters,
bro. Tournament includes new teams, new players, and new logos. Take a look at all the teams, courtesy of 99 Designs by Vistaprint. 99 Designs by Vistaprint designed many of the team logos for this year's event. See what they can do for you. Well, we have come to the end of our first Sunday semifinal. And Boeheim's Army has the basketball after the two Kenny Boynton free throws. And that set the target score at 66. And Boeheim's Army has got some getting to do.
They've got to figure out how to guard Clanton. He's got 16, 16, and 3 assists. They've got to find a way to get to the line. They're averaging 18 free throws a game. They've only got to the line 7 times. Settled to shoot threes.
Kick out to Kane. And Clanton got his 17th rebound. The ball's out of bounds to Florida TNT. Or is it? Nope. Pointed the wrong way. Boeheim's Army has it.
Boeheim's Army is 4 for 24 from the three-point line. Instead of racking it and getting to the basket, now that was a good open look. They've got to have better offensive possession. This would be a good look.
McCullough. Boynton has it. Push ahead to Jones.
Clanton, such a tough matchup right here. You got to get up and under, pressure the basketball. They've got to figure out how they're going to guard on these back downs. These back downs, eventually someone's got to go after him. I wouldn't leave Boynton, though. Good cut right
Jones
there.
Jones spins it out. Spurlock missed the three. And it remains 58-53. 66 points wins it. Rice, a pull-up three. Got it. Here he goes again, just like yesterday, heating up in the Elamending.
How good has he been in the Elamending? Now they got to get a clean stop. And this, the guy that needs to be shooting threes, Sykes and Rice are the three-point shooters on the floor right now. Everyone else should be playing downhill and making plays at the rim.
Chris Warren, his three pops out, and a foul on Clanton. ...58-56. Three team fouls on each team. So one to give.
I put Clanton in a ball screen and I would back screen him out of there because and make him recover back. Here comes the ball screen right there, Clanton. Now you gotta go at him.
McCullough. Rice back door, flips it in. And the game score is tied at 58. Both clubs now 8 points away.
Good job of playing without the ball. They denied Rice the ball back. What does he do? He back cuts. Great job and terrific pass. Someone's got to find Clanton.
Trying to wrap it around. Clanton can't hang on to it. Boeheim's Army, here they come. Rice, good! My goodness! Timeout for Florida TNT. Tyrese Rice taking over the Elamending. They are 5 points away and all of it on the shoulders of Tyrese Rice.
Now, Travis Steeter said something really interesting the other day about the Elamending. He said, you gotta have someone on your team that's willing to step up and live with the consequence. And Tyrese Rice is one of those guys that's willing in the Elamending to step up and live, make or miss. Great job, but more importantly, they finally decided to dig the ball out in the post. Better job defensively, got him out in transition.
Dominate on three, 1, 2, 3.
Dominate on so-so. Let's finish this thing.
Florida TNT has led the entire afternoon, it seems, until this guy starts cooking. Tyrese Rice, yesterday against the Golden Eagles, he scored 8 of Boeheim Army's last 9 in the Elamending, and he's got all 8 so far in this Elamending. That's our EJ turning point.
I mean, the dude got 46 against Carolina as a junior. He's got over 2,000 points in his career. He went to the Sweet 16 at Boston College. He's played at the very highest level in Europe, Eurocup.
E&J is proud to partner with the National Urban League to empower communities. 61-58. Boeheim's Army 5 points away. Florida TNT needs a hoop in the worst way. A drive and a foul. And this will be a shooting foul, putting Tristan Spurlock to the line.
I like what Boeheim's Army, at least they were active, did a good job in a scramble situation defensively. We got to keep track of those fouls now. All right, Boeheim's Army, that's their fourth foul. That next time they foul, it's going to be one in the ball for Florida TNT.
Spurlock breaks the Elam ending ice for Florida TNT. They are seven away.
If I'm Boeheim's Army, I'm going to put Bryce in some type of ball screen, but make sure we have a hard roll or a short roll, because they're definitely going to commit two to him.
Opportunity lost here for Florida TNT. Every free throw in the Elam ending, crucial. Boeheim's Army.
Watch McCullough coming off of his screen here.
Rice. Steal by Kane.
That's DeAndre Kane doing DeAndre Kane things. 50-50 balls. That's why he's won in the Elam ending. That's why he's won in the TBT.
And the foul coming on Spurlock. And that brings Florida TNT to four team fouls.
All right, Coach Bob, what do they got to do now if you're Boeheim's Army?
Well, when you're five up with the ball, you get a great look. You've got them in the penalty.
Yeah, this guy, you drive it and get to the line.
There you go. And there is a block by Dominic Jones and a foul on Boeheim's Army.
Great individual defensive effort right there. I would have loved to see Kane work his way in. You got to find some space and then spray that thing out. But that's a really good individual defense. But now, here it is. Free throw and the ball. Potential for a four-point play for Florida TNT.
Dominic Jones with the lane vacant. That gives them 60 points, six away. But as you so accurately pointed out, Seth Greenberg, this is where the penalty kills you. The other team maintains possession. Dominic Jones out front against Kane. Is he going to try to take him?
Defend without fouling, keep it in front, force a contested shot and rebound to miss.
Dominic Jones, wild shot, end of the clock.
Boeheim's Army, you got to play faster earlier in transition and then get into it. Boynton's such a good on-ball defender. Long arms active. Watch how they commit two defenders every single time he comes off a ball screen.
Rice moves in between two defenders, a block and a foul.
And that's going to be a two-shot foul, because if you fouled in the act of shooting, you don't get the ball back. They would have been better off if that was on the ground, where they would have got the possession back.
If Rice can knock these two down, Boeheim's Army will come down the next time in a three to win it.
Or a drive to get to the line and then a two to win it.
Or an old-fashioned three, right. Tyrese Rice. He's taking over for Marcus Keane with the Elam Enders. He's been magnificent.
And this is a Boeheim's Army team that has not shot well from the free throw line, but when in the Elam ending, you've got to finish. You get to the line, you can't have empty possessions. What's up? Wait.
Both teams over the limit, and it pops out. So now TNT needs six. You don't need threes per se, but you've got to get something good. Last couple of possessions, Seth, they've been nailed to the end of the shot clock. Dominic Jones moves in, nice fake, drops it in, and TNT is four away.
really good spacing on that possession. I'd like to see Kiefer Sykes look to be a little more aggressive right now. It's a tough matchup on Boynton. All right, they're totally denying Tyrese Rice the ball.
This Elam ending is so interesting. So much strategy. How do you play it? Where do you go?
I might right now, and it sounds like it's outside the box, I might right now bring in Andrew White, bring in another offensive player.
Let's go, fellas.
What are we doing?
No fouls, no threes.
No. Hey, whatever you want to do. Hey. No, hey, we cannot foul. We cannot foul.
Whatever you want to do.
Stay solid. Let's go. Stay solid on defense. Stay solid on defense. Execute on offense. Let's go. Dominate. 1, 2, 3.
Dominate.
Good job, man.
That says it all. Both teams in the penalty. That's what makes this Elam ending so great. You get to the end of a college game, and it's the foul game for the team trailing. Now, of course, we're tied here in the overall score, but you don't have that in the Elam ending.
No, you've got to defend without fouling. And I'll tell you the other thing you got to do is you better get the ball in bounds.
DJ Kennedy. McCullough. Unable to pull the trigger. Now Rice jammed up on the wing. Still plenty of time on the clock here for Boeheim's Army. Boy, Dominique Jones, that was dangerous. He got away with a lot of contact. We're down to 4-3. Rice with a heave. No. Rebound to Florida TNT. Here comes Kenny Boynton.
Getting the ball in bounds and getting the ball in offense is really a hard thing.
And Florida TNT is going to take a timeout. They're last.
You can't have wasted possessions in the Elam ending. You've got to be able to get the ball, and you know that they're going to be blitzing and trapping the ball screens on Rice. You've got to be set up in some type of short roll. Let's hear what they're going to go right now on the other end.
Should we get CJ for Chris right now? Or no? CJ for Chris right now? No. Hey, we got a front to big coming down. So that means you got to go over, Chris. Whoever guard is setting the back screen, you got to get under and understand that Chris is going over. Then you got to attach again because it's little ass Warren setting it. So we got to be really good on that weak side. Y'all can touch the lane line. They just want to punch it to him.
Bump him. Knock over his face.
All right, then go in front. Hey, coming down next time, we got to play basketball.
No timeout. Bring it in. Hey, bring it in. Dominate.
Strong screens. Oh, they just don't run.
Dominate.
Boeheim's Army, what they got to do is got to defend without fouling. They talked about any type of back screen that they're going to go ball side because they're going to try to front clamp in the low post. On the other end, he says, just play basketball. I'll tell you what, they got to get the ball moving, and the ball can't get stuck. But right now, defensively, one shot only, defend without fouling, and keep the game in front.
Chris Warren.
On the bounce, you got to go. You got to go. You can't go halfway. You got to go off of Kennedy.
Clanton, fouled. 2 free throws.
You got to make him get to the line. That's better than a lay-in for sure, but you've got to look. You got to either bluff and recover or double the post and rotate off the backside. You let him get 2 feet in the paint, it is hard to defend. And I'll tell you, I thought McCullough did a good job trying to body up and wall up.
Clanton bangs in. Florida TNT's 63rd point, so they're 3 away. Lots of crazy things can happen here at the end of the Elam ending. Team 23 and Blue Collar U at 230. And it's 2 points away now for TNT. Clanton's going to get a breather. In comes Spurlock to defend. And now Boeheim's Army. Warren knocks it out of the hands of Rice.
It's really important for Boeheim's Army right now to get to the free throw line. It's really important for them not to settle. TNT does not want to foul. You've got to find a way to play quicker, get to the free throw line, and add an extra possession.
And no matter what happens, TNT is going to come down the court with a chance to win it. Rice. Both teams 2 points away now. Advantage Florida TNT. They've got the basketball. Kenny Boynton to Dominique Jones.
And the advantage is out of the game. Clanton is out of the game, so this is going to be someone making a play off the bounce here. Guy that has an NBA championship ring against Kane, a terrific on-ball defender.
Dominique. No! McCullough the rebound, and Boeheim's Army takes a timeout with a chance to win it.
DeAndre Kane's getting all lost in the moment. Good, you got to stop. You got to make a play at the other end right there. Good job of putting him on his chest. Kane with enough of a contested shot, and who comes up to rebound? McCullough.
Jeremy Pope in the Boeheim huddle.
Please, I'm coming to you. I got you, but it's coming to you.
Can you just drive the ball?
We just gonna ghost it. Come from here, run up and fly out. Wait, Reese, if you get fouled, you get the two free throws and the ball back.
Yeah, the focal point right now is if you ball screen Tyrese Rice, what they're gonna do is trap the ball, get the ball out of his hand. So what they're gonna try to do is set a ghost screen for Tyrese. What that means is the guy's gonna run to set the screen, whomever it is, and then they're gonna sprint out, which is gonna open up the floor. The problem is I look for Florida TNT to stay on that double. So they're gonna get the ball out of his hands. Most important thing right now, get the ball inbounds. Play downhill and get to the offense glass of your Boeheim Army. Defensive rebound, force a contested shot of your Florida TNT.
Unlike the NBA, no advancement of the basketball. They've got to bring it up 94 feet. And they are looking to win on the Elam Ender here. First team to 66.
I like this. Open floor.
Rice misses. Now, Florida TNT with a second chance to win. Kenny Boynton. A berth in the championship game, and Rice with a steal! Fumbles it, lays it in! And Boeheim's Army wins it! Tyrese Rice got the ball back under control and laid it in after the steal. He dominated the Elam ending for Boeheim's Army. They're going to give him an honorary degree after this performance.
You can't make this stuff up, the Elam ending. It's absolutely unbelievable.
Wild.
The different ways you can win a game or lose a game is absolutely incredible. Inside hand down, turnover. Jen's going to visit with Tyrese Rice. Terrific late game play.
66-64 is the final. Let's go to Jen with the hero.
That play was so awesome by Tyrese Rice. Florida TNT had to come over and congratulate him too. Tyrese, what an amazing finish. Walk me through that steal and that basket. Once again, another Elam Ender for you.
I don't even know. I really don't know, man. We just had to get a stop. You know, I missed a shot before. Felt like I owed it to the team to try to get a stop. He tried to ice on me. He'd been hesitating the whole game. I knew he would have to switch his move up. He switched his move. He put it in my hands.
Before the Elam ending, literally, Boeheim's Army only led for 30 seconds in this game. It seemed hard for you to find your rhythm, find your energy. What was the key to closing out and finding all of that for those last Elam ending
points? Don't matter. Just fight. Just fight to the end. We've been winning ugly games the entire tournament. like I've been telling people the whole time, if we play six ugly games, we're going to win six ugly games because we got better closers than a lot of people. So we're just trying to get to close the game, and that's it.
Thanks for your time. Enjoy the win.
I will, for sure.
Bob?
Okay, Jen. Miraculous Boeheim Army win. Incredible. They have done it again. They have stared at defeat seemingly in every TBT game they played, Seth, but they find a way, and Rice has been spectacular in the Elam ending.
They come out, they're not ready to play, they take bad shots, they turn it over, and they just grind away and get ugly wins. And there's Jen with Big Daddy DeAndre King.
Yeah, guys, we had to talk to DeAndre after all the dirty work he did today. So many hustle plays, DeAndre. You were the one out there communicating, talking, lifting your teammates up. You were so hungry for this one.
Yeah, I mean, you know, after missing a year, and then losing to Ohio State the year before that. You know, me and DJ wanted to come back and try to help any team we can win. And these guys are relentless, man. They welcome us to the team with open arms, and it feels good to be part of something special, man. That group right there is something special, man.
What sets them apart? What makes them different? Because you have played on a lot of winning teams. The tradition you had with Overseas Elite, incomparable so far.
It's a lot of difference. You know, OE, we had a lot of chemistry. We played together for a while. You know, we all really just joined this team. This is like 10, 11 guys, a new group of guys, fresh group of guys, and we came along and we gelled right away. So, like I said, it's been fun playing with these guys, and we got one more to finish it off.
Yes, you do. Congratulations. We will see you Tuesday night.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
Bob.
What up, bro?
Great game. Let's take a look at our turning point brought to you by E&J Brandy and the National Urban League. Oh, the twists and turns of an Elam ending. A steal off Kenny Boynton. And what a shot by Tyrese Rice. I thought for an instant, Seth, when he bobbled the ball, that he was in trouble, but he got it back and laid it in. E&J is proud to partner with the National Urban League to empower communities.
Yeah, Tyrese Rice, inside hand down. You talk about ball pressure, you get your inside hand down to take away the crossover. Rice gets deflection, and this is what it's all about, baby. Big Daddy DeAndre King climbing the ladder, smacking that thing on. You are one game away from $1 million.
DeAndre King with the honor. For the first time in Boeheim Army TBT history, they will play for the championship.
And the incredible thing is, and I think Tyrese Rice said it best, the uglier the game gets, almost the better it is for them. I mean, they can get to the end of the game. They do have closers. Sykes is close. Obviously, DeAndre King comes up with loose balls. Tyrese Rice gets to the rim and makes plays. They didn't play well today. They better figure out what they're going to do in their post defense if someone gets it going. But they keep on grinding, and they motivate each other. I mean, like Bob, if you look at some of those timeouts, they're a little bit dysfunctional. But they all challenge each other, and they hold each other accountable, which is kind of interesting. And if the players hold each other accountable, then it's easier for other coaches. And they better figure out a couple things late clock offensively, but that's a heck of a win against a really good Florida TNT team. And Kenny Boyd, what a terrific player. Kind of hard to see him make that play down the stretch.
Boeheim's Army is in the championship. Team 23 and Blue Collar U to decide the other opponent's berth in the championship game. And coming up next, real fun event. The three-point contest is the 33-point contest. And eight players go head-to-head. And when you get to 11 made threes, you advance.
It's a great event. I'm looking at the Dominator, Fran Camp, and Hannes as my three favorites coming into this thing. You know what the key thing in the 33 is? The rebounder and the passer. Because if you miss one, that guy better chase it down and get it back to you.
Because right. You don't know what's going on at the other end.
It's the first of 33. And, you know, getting back to our game, it resonates in my mind talking to Travis Steiner about having the want to have the ball at the end of the game. Rice has that ability. We got another game coming up. Let me tell you, Team 23, the longest, most athletic team against Blue Collar U.
who's got this game broken down. They got the whole Alabama staff working on stats and scouting reports. This is going to be unbelievable.
Well, stay with us. We've got more coverage coming from Dayton with the 33-point contest. That's going to be so exciting. Seth and I will be back at 2:30 Eastern time with the final game and set the championship on Tuesday night. You gotta love TBT and the Elam ending. It is so exciting. Stay with us. More coverage coming up from Dayton, Ohio.